Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cool summer fruit soup. The fruits I'm using for this soup are strawberries, blueberries, and peaches. And I'll have to prepare these, but I wanted you to see what the fruits were because we're going to mix up a sauce to go over them. The sauce is composed of a little bit of cornstarch. We'll start with 2 tablespoons of cornstarch and put that into a pot that can go on the stove in just a minute. And then I've got a cup of water here that I will be using, but I'm just going to pour about 1/4 cup in to mix this around. So we'll just stir this around, and that's to get the cornstarch dissolved so you won't have any lumps or anything. And that's looking pretty good. There's a little bit there in that area. I think I've got it. So I'm going to add the rest of that water. So a total of 1 cup of water goes in. Next, I'm going to put some pineapple juice in. If you prefer to use a different juice, just think of something that would go with the flavor of the berries and peaches and also the rest of this little sauce. And you may substitute maybe apple juice or something like that. You need 3/4 cup of fruit juice, and this is pineapple juice. Just put it in there. Next, you have maple syrup, or an imitation of maple syrup. Mine is just an imitation, so don't follow exactly what I have here. If you have maple syrup, pure maple syrup, you'd like to use that, you need 3/4 cup. So whatever you would like that is maple flavored and is a syrup, 3/4 cup goes in. And we have one thing down here on the end, which is lemon juice. And I'm just using the bottled kind because I don't have any fresh lemons right now. But if you want to use the fresh, you can. And I have 1 teaspoon of the bottled lemon juice. We're putting that in. Now I'm going to stir this around, and it's not hard to blend at all because we already got the lumps out of the cornstarch. I'm coming over to the stove. You'll see this is a nice tan color. Don't know if you can really see that, but I'm going to put this over medium heat and bring it to a boil. And I will stir constantly while it's coming to a boil. Once it reaches a boil, we're going to boil it 1 minute. Then it needs to be cooled. So I'll let it cool naturally to room temperature. Then I will chill it in the refrigerator. And that gives me plenty of time to prepare my fruits. So I'll have them all washed and sliced or whatever they need for the particular fruit. And then we'll pour this chilled sauce over it, and it's going to taste wonderful. Our sauce for our cool summer fruit soup is ready for us to use. I let it cool at room temperature for a while, then I put it in the refrigerator for a couple of hours, and it's nice and cold. So what I'm going to do is place my fruits in there and then transfer to a nice serving bowl. The fruits that I have are 2 cups of chopped peaches, and just chop them about like that. You want them to be not too much larger than your other items. Here we have 1 cup of sliced strawberries. You want to slice them so they'll have this pretty look to them. Every time you slice a strawberry and it shows the inner parts of it, it really makes a pretty design. So we have 1 cup of those. And then all you do in preparing your blueberries is just wash them and drain them. There might be an occasional stem that you need to pick out, or there might be a shriveled berry, but we have 1 cup of those. So I'm just going to add those to my sauce, and if I find that I feel like there's too much sauce, I don't have to dip all of the sauce out into the serving bowl, just the amount that I want to use. So we get our blueberries and strawberries, 1 cup each, but 2 cups of the peaches. Get those put in with our sauce mixture and just blend that around. And then have waiting for it an appropriate dish. I think a clear bowl is always nice for something that is this colorful. And I think I will leave all of that sauce in there because this actually is a soup. It's not meant to be a fruit salad. In that case, maybe I would want to drain it and leave the taste of that sauce on it. But in this case, we really want the sauce as part of what gets eaten. So I'll just pour until I feel like it's attractive enough and then stop if I have too much. But I think this is going to be just right. So that's what it looks like in the bowl. I missed a little over here, I didn't see. So just try to stir this around until the fruits are distributed in a pleasant way. You don't want a whole clump of peaches in one spot and the strawberries somewhere else and the blueberries all in the center or something like that. This looks pretty nice. So that's what it's going to look like when you place it on your buffet table or your serving table. Now I'd like to show you how I might do an individual serving. So right over here I have a plate, and on that plate I have my soup bowl, and I've chosen clear in all cases. And usually I have crackers with soup, but with a fruit soup you don't want a salty cracker necessarily, so I chose ginger snaps. Here's a box. These are just generic ginger snaps. You can make your own fresh, that would be really nice. But a cookie like that that's crisp along with this soup is going to be great. And then these two strawberries are just for some garnish. And we'll dip out what we can here. Remembering that we want to get some soup in there as well as our fruits. And this is kind of drippy, so it's a little bit hard to get it placed in without using a big soup ladle. Should have gotten one of those out. But the final look of our dish today is this. So let me put it over here on its plate, and here is the spoon to go with it, and it's ready to go. I hope you enjoy it.